Friends, in the last video, after watching the story of the rabbit and the fox, we learned to identify the traced feet and also learned how to trace objects from surroundings. In this video, along with Thumbkin and Tall Man, we will understand the shapes we get when we trace the objects from the surroundings.
Friends, did you practice tracing of objects?
Yes. So now tell me, which shape would we get when we trace these solid-shaped blocks?
First of all, we will keep hexagon pyramid on a paper and trace it.
The base of this hexagon pyramid is hexagon. Friends, you know what? When we trace any object, the shape we get will be the same as the base.
Yes, so when we will keep this hexagon pyramid on paper and trace it, we will get the hexagon shape.
Now we will trace the square pyramid.
Here, the base of the square pyramid is square.
Yes, we will get square shape when we will trace this pyramid.
Look, this is a cylindrical shape.
The base of a cylinder shape is a circle. So, we will get a circle shape when we trace the cylinder shape.
Yes, so when we trace these solid shapes, we will get the shapes hexagon, square and circle according to their bases.
Now let's look at another example.
Look, which shapes would we get if we will put this bowl and glass straight and upside down and then trace them?
If we keep the bowl and glass straight like this, their base is a circle.
Yes. So, if we keep the bowl and glass upward and trace them, then we will get the circle shape.
Now, if we will keep the bowl and the glass upside down like this, then?
The base of the bowl is square and the base of the glass is a circle.
If we keep the bowl facing downward and trace it, then we will get the square shape. And if we keep the glass facing downward and trace it, then we will get the circle shape.
You are right. So, if we keep the bowl straight and trace it, then we will get a circle shape. And if we keep it upside down and trace it, then we will get a square shape.
And if we keep the glass straight and trace it, then we will get a small circle shape. And if we keep it upside down and trace it, then we will get a bigger circle. Friends, in this video, we understood the shapes we get when we trace objects from our surroundings. In the next video, we will understand some interesting facts relating to tracing with the help of Thumbkin and Tall Man.